I think like a lot of people coming into university are like, there's so many people, but how do I make friends? On the first day of class, to be honest, I scout the classroom and be like, okay, let's see who's in my class this term. It's definitely a lot nerve-wracking to approach someone, but I think it's worth it.
I think it's really easy to make friends through study groups. Catherine being in CMS and myself being in integrated sciences, these are programs where you don't necessarily have a lot of classes with your peers.
Being in the same faculty, like a lot of our classes overlap, we just ended up being friends afterwards.
It's always easier to study with a friend than study alone, and so we decided to work together on a lot of the projects and study together, discussing different topics to make sure we were on track, and we had a little group chat.
It was very easy to just text a group chat, be like, anyone on campus want to study together? And just having like that companionship to study, it keeps you motivated. At least for myself, I get in my head sometimes, but then if I know that my friends are also in the same situation, it kind of keeps me relaxed because I know we're all going through the same thing.
You need that friendship and that moral support as well as that academic support.
Sugar always gives me like those words of affirmation. Right? So she's always like, you can do it.
Catherine always keeps me grounded and is like, let's take a break. You need a break. Which is so important for someone to make you remember that school isn't everything. There's more to life than school. And
don't stress over the little things. Normally, if you're studying by yourself or trying to solve a problem by yourself, you get stuck on something, you don't really know what to do because you're kind of stuck. If you're studying with someone who's also studying the same thing, solving those problems together as like a collaborative effort, you tend to find the answer a lot quicker.
I think what you're studying for also has a big impact on how you're going to study with your group. For example, if you are doing an assignment, you might just all be sitting there like working on your own, but then you might need someone to review your work. So you might just pass your laptops off, review each other's work and pass them back. Whereas other times when you're studying, sometimes it's nice to draw out what you're studying and try and collaboratively solve the problems.
Some of the benefits I see studying with other people is that it's a chance to collaborate with others. You also keep each other on track.
I think for me, what helped a lot with studying with groups is that I just would learn a lot from my peers, not just about school, but about life and what you might want to do after school.
Study groups can come in different shapes and sizes. I always recommend just start with one person, find that one person who you can study with, and then you can find more people to add to it.
I think your mental health plays such a big role, and study groups really help relieve your stress and help you feel supported. And I think that's so important when you are in such a high stress environment like sciences. So I would highly recommend trying to find a study group if you can. And if it's something you're struggling with, there's always ways to find a study group. Sometimes your TAs will hold office hours and you can meet people that way. Or sometimes it's just as easy as talking to the person next to you and adding them on Facebook and getting them to study with you.